Hi, I'm Dr. Johnny, and today we're doing male Botox and Dysport. Now, I'll take and show you a patient today, but it's become very, very popular because we can achieve such a natural, approachable look for the male patient that comes on gradually, not suddenly all at once. Let's go, we'll treat a patient and talk about it further. So with our male patient, I'm going to take you through the most common areas we treat. Now, frown down for me here. We already treated this area and there's not a lot of movement. That's a gateway for the rest of the treatments because it's a home run, it lifts the eyes, you don't have that frown or untoward look, and especially for business people, makes people approachable. So now we're gonna treat the forehead, which is the next common area, and we soften the area around the eyes. We don't remove all the lines in the male patient. One of the things we're noting is what we talked about, a little bit of mid-face volume loss. So we're not building a high cheek. He already has a great cheek for a male, but what we're doing is looking to see what we might do with fillers. Now, to stick with our Botox or Dysport treatments, the male sometimes grinds and has a strong jaw. So we might treat the masters, however, understanding if we were to treat his, he would lose some of that nice jawline that he already has. So in this case, unless he was grinding and losing teeth, I would not treat the masseters because aesthetically, I want actually a little more volume here. We don't do a lot of DAOs in males, but oftentimes if we want the mouth to turn up, we add less fillers. So neuromodulators like our Botox and Dysport injected here at the depressor anguli oris works real well. Platysma bands are also common for male patients, but remember we talked about they have better skin, and so oftentimes they don't get as much loose skin as a female, and the bands treat actually very well in the males for that reason. So let's go up to the forehead and we'll do our treatments. And remember, in the female, we want a nice mid-arch brow. And that's why we don't treat right above the brow. In a male, we're allowed to have a flatter, straighter brow. And typically, there's more bony prominence and forward projection in the male patient. So let's get our patient to raise your eyebrows up so we know our pattern of treatment. Okay, there we go. So now you can relax it. I'm going to treat. And we're just really micro-dosing a few units along the area we see the muscle move. Remember, the forehead muscle is a thin muscle and it divides variably, okay? So some people, it will divide this way early. Others, it comes right to the top. And so we have to look at the pattern of movement. Now, in a male patient can present the problem of the hairline is further back than a female. So raise for me, raise your eyebrows. Not a lot of movement up here, we're lucky. That's going to, and you can relax, thank you. That's gonna save him money in terms of we don't have to treat all the way back to that region. Now I'm gonna tilt you my way and I'll get you to move again and raise up for me. Great, so now you can relax. I see a little movement centrally here. Whether the muscle is there or not, we never truly know because of how it divides. But we treat it anyway. And again, here, we're going to treat just above the brow and then a little above, cleansing the area. And this is very quick injections. Doesn't take long, but the effect is great and patients love that. We don't want to remove all the lines in the male patient. And below is to treat with platelet-rich fibrin, not Botox or Dysport. Now you can, I actually do give males a little bit of a brow lift by treating the downward fibers or of the orbicularis oculi. So we do want to get a little brow lift, but it's not going to be enough to lift it up too high. So there's one side. We'll come over and we'll treat the other side. In this region, I'm going to tilt you this way a little bit. Again, that's the downward fibers of the orbicularis oculi. These are superficial. A lot of people make the mistake of injecting this deep. These are not intramuscular. They're very baby superficial injections. And that event prevents a bruise and it works just as well. And you can see there's almost no bleeding at all. In and out, patients like that result. So that's a male patient with Botox and Dysport. If you have any further questions, ask on this YouTube channel. Join us on Instagram, YouTube, and Facebook for continued helpful tips. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.